हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, नेक्स्ट चैप्टर इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक इंडक्शन। ओके, व्हाट इज इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक इंडक्शन? द फेनोमेनन ऑफ इंड्यूस्ड ईएमएफ इन अ कॉइल ड्यू टू चेंज इन मैग्नेटिक फ्लक्स इज नोन एज व्हाट वी कॉल इट इज इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक इंडक्शन। द डेफिनेशन वी नो दैट। ओके, फर्स्ट हियर फ्लक्स, व्हाट इज फ्लक्स? द नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड लाइंस पासिंग थ्रू अ क्लोज सरफेस एरिया इज नोन एज व्हाट वी कॉल इट इज फ्लक्स, मैग्नेटिक फ्लक्स। दैट वी आर राइटिंग y equals integral of B dot dA, okay, area, okay, dot product is removed using a cos theta, BA cos theta, okay. Here, the first electromagnetic induction phenomena was explained by Henry and Faraday, Here I am stating Faraday's law. Okay, what is Faraday's law? States, induced EMF in a coil, due to the rate of change of magnetic flux is known as what we call it is Faraday's law. Here we are writing the equation. That is Faraday's law. Epsilon equals to minus n d pi by dt. What is the pi indicates? Pi indicates the flux. Okay. That we are writing. Pi equals to change n, n into pi 2 minus pi 1 divided by delta t. Okay, now this again pi can be expressed in terms of magnetic field and area. A into b 2 minus b 1 divided by delta t cos theta. Right? Okay, now again that we are expressing in terms of cos theta also. If b is taken to be constant, okay, magnetic field is constant. If the angle is changing, okay, minus nba cos theta 2 minus cos theta 1 divided by delta t. Okay, this equation again I am using by solving the problems. Okay, but in this point the EMF is induced as well as current also induces. That current we are writing, current equals to I equals to V by R, that is E by R I am writing here, that is V by R, that is V is nothing but what? EMF, epsilon, right? Epsilon equals to N by R d pi by dt. Okay, now the induced charge, what is induced charge? Q equals to current into time. Okay, again current I am writing minus N by R into d pi. Delta the dt and dt get cancelled. What we are getting here? Dq equals to minus N by R into d pi. Okay, remember this one. But power also, the induced power is, what is power? We know that the power equals to V into I. Power equals to what? V into I. That is power equals to V into I, or we can write that E square divided by R. Or we can write that E square divided by R. Again here, E value we know that, otherwise I value will be there by substituting that N square by R into d pi by dt whole square. N square by R into d pi by dt whole square. Remember, the power and as well as the power and charge and current, this equation will be very helpful by solving the problems. Okay. Now we move to the Lenz law. What Lenz law states? Induced, that is this law gives the direction of induced EMF and current. Direction of induced EMF and current. What is direction here? Resistance here I written. Epsilon equals to this. Actually Faraday not explained the minus sign, but actually that given by Lenz. Okay, that is the polarity. Minus or plus sign given. Okay, that's Lenz law states. Like it gives the direction of induced EMF and current in a loop. Okay. Now here, when we are moving towards the formulas, that is motional EMF. Motional EMF due to a translational motion. Okay, what is translation? Only one direction motion. Okay. Here we consider uniform magnetic field. What I consider here? Uniform magnetic field. I consider this uniform magnetic field, a rectangular loop is placed. We consider uniform magnetic field. Uniform magnetic field consists of, in this uniform magnetic field, what we place here? A rectangular loop is placed. Okay, P, Q, R, S. Okay, P, Q is freely movable. P, Q is freely movable. We can move easily. P, Q is freely movable. When P, Q is moved inside the magnetic field, what will happen? the EMF or current is induced. Current is induced in the coil. If current is induced by deriving the derivation, what you can get here? Epsilon equals to BLV. You can use epsilon equals to BLV. Current induced in a circuit is, or EMF induced in a circuit is epsilon equals to BLV. What is current? That is I equals to BLV divided by R. First one is EMF is induced in a loop is epsilon equals to BLV and current equals to BLV divided by R. Okay? Remember these two formula by solving the problems very well. Okay, here I am. So current BLV divided by R. Okay? Now, that is the magnetic force on a conductor. Right? Here only the consideration of energy formula, energy we derived in excited theory, okay, that I considered here. What is the formula for force experience? The force experience in a conductor, F equals to B square B, L square divided by R, B square B, L square divided by R, okay, the force experience by a conductor, right? Okay, now, here, the power get dissipated. What is happening here? Power get dissipated. What is the formula of power get dissipated? P equals to okay, that is that formula right here. P equals to force into velocity. What is the formula? Force into velocity. What is the formula we are having, students? Force. Force equals to B square V, L square divided by R into V. Right? Okay, by simplifying that, what we can get here? P equals to B square, L square divided by, B square, L square divided by R is power dissipated in a conductor. Okay, remember this. Okay. Motional EMF due to rotational motion. Motional EMF due to rotational motion. So let's here consider an electromagnetic field. This is an electromagnetic field. Right? What I'll place? It will place a circular conducting loop. Okay? Then O. P is a freely movable part. When this rod moves a circular path, the EMF is induced in the circuit. What is the EMF is induced? See, this rod is moving in a circular path. It is experiencing the angular velocity. What is it experiencing? It is experiencing the angular velocity. This derivation will derive in terms of angular velocity. That is, epsilon equals to BL squared omega divided by BL square omega divided by. That is omega. Omega equals to 2 pi. That we are writing here. Epsilon equals to 1 by 2 B omega L square is the EMF induced in a conducting loop in a circular path. Okay? Now, here, in an electromagnetic field, what we are placing? A rectangular loop is placed, then it starts experiencing the torque. What is experiencing? It is experiencing the torque. It experiences the torque, that torque we are writing here. Okay? This is EMF, epsilon equals to d pi by dt, minus d pi by dt, nb omega sin omega t. Nb omega sin omega t. Is the EMF induced in the this loop. Okay? That we get. Epsilon equals to NBA omega sin omega. That equation we can get here. So that is epsilon equals to that is minus d pi. Pi is nothing but that I am writing. BA cos omega t divided by. Okay, now epsilon equals by differentiating. Okay, that is minus 2 minus plus BA omega, right? cos differentiation is minus sine. Sine omega minus into minus plus. Okay, omega t. Omega t differentiation, just omega. What do you get, students? B A omega sine omega. But how many number of terms are there here? N number of terms. How many number of terms are there here? N number of terms. That we are writing N number of terms. N B A omega sine omega. Okay. Induced, what is the induced current? That induced current we are writing epsilon by R. Okay, epsilon by R. By substituting that, what you can get? NBA omega divided by R. Okay, now here I will the self inductance of a point. Is that a self inductance? What is self inductance? By itself, self is nothing but itself. Okay, itself, it induces EMF. How it is induces? Okay, that we know that in NCERT theory. Okay, here just I will define that. The EMF induced due to the rate of change of current. EMF induced due to the rate of change of current. That we are writing. Epsilon directly proportional to d pi by d. Epsilon is directly proportional to d pi by d. Okay, now the proportionality constant is removed. Proportionality constant is removed, minus L d pi by minus L d pi by d. What is the equation we got? Epsilon equals to minus L d pi by d is the equation. Minus L equals to minus L d pi by d. Okay, students, remember this equation. Now, the self-inductance of a solenoid. Self inductance of a solenoid. And equation we are getting. The self inductance of a solenoid. L equals to mu naught n square a into L. Then and this one we can simplify. L is nothing but what? Number of turns per unit length. Then you can just take a number of turns. That is a L. N by L square. Then L and L get cancelled. This equation we can get. That is mu naught capital N A divided by remember this. Okay? Mu naught capital N A divided by L. Okay. If ferromagnetic material is placed, this is a soft what we consider soft iron core wound with a number of turns. Okay? Now, then what is the equation we got? If ferromagnetic material is placed, what we can get the equation? Then the medium is changed. That medium we are writing relative permeability, L equals to mu naught n square a divided by L. mu naught n square a divided by L. When we get this equation, when a ferromagnetic material is placed inside the soft iron core, then you can get this. Remember, students. Okay. Now, energy stored in a solenoid. Very important formula. Energy stored in a solenoid. What is the energy stored in a solenoid? U equals to 1 by 2 L I square. Energy stored in a solenoid. L is a coefficient of self inductance. I is a current. Okay. Now, then we'll move to the, what are the factors, on what factors this self-inductance depends? The self-inductance depends, okay, this question is asked in the Karnataka State CT exam. First one, length of the coil, number of turns of the coil, then cross-sectional area, then permeability of the medium. First, medium, cross-sectional area, number of turns and length. Remember this. Mutual inductance. What is mutual inductance? Mutual is nothing but two coils. This is first coil and this is second coil, placer one another, right? Then what is the end expression? The end expression is, first I will define the mutual inductance. Mutual inductance, the rate of change of current, the EMF is induced in a coil, is known as what is called this mutual inductance. Okay, that we are writing epsilon epsilon is directly proportional to, what is directly proportional to d pi by d. Okay, the proportionality constant is removed. Proportionality constant is removed. That what we can write here, epsilon equals to minus m d pi by d. Okay, what does m indicates? M indicates coefficient of mutual inductance. Coefficient of mutual inductance. Okay. Now, for mutual inductance of a solenoid, the pair of solenoid, then here two coils are placed one another. Then just I will tell the expression. Mutual inductance of first coil and second coil. What is the expression? Mu naught mu r. L1 into pi r square into L square. Length of capital L and small l. Capital L and small l. This is capital L and the one is small l. Then the expression is, because this is first coil and this is second coil, when current flows through it, the first coil will induce the EM. And that when current flows through first coil, second coil will induce the EM. Yes, we know that. Now, uses of eddy current. Uses of eddy current. Eddy current definition, we know that. Okay, where we are using this one? This we are using in an induction furnace. We are using this one. First one is, we are using an induction furnace and speedometer, galvanometer, dead galvanometer, and then next one is electromagnetic train we are using. Okay, now AC generator. Okay, what is the AC generator? AC generator is a device. It is a device to generate a mechanical, that is AC current is known as AC generator. V equals to NVA omega sin omega. Okay, remember this. Okay, go through all these formulas. Okay, that is, first one is AC generator and equation, that is V equals to NAB omega sin omega t. The next one, that is mutual inductance. Okay, self-inductance is all the formulas you remember. Based on these formulas, I will solve the questions. Okay, here. Professionals, first question. We'll take the first question, students. What is the first question here? A coil of area 100 centimeters square has 500 tons magnetic field of 0.1 Weber per meter square is perpendicular to the coil. The field is reduced to zero in 0.1 second. The induced EMF in a coil is, okay, students, first equation, Faraday's equation I use. Epsilon equals to minus d pi by dt. But d pi by dt I'll simplify in terms of magnetic. That is, epsilon equals to minus n into v2 minus v1 a divided by d. Okay, now epsilon equals to, how many turns are there in this one? 5 into V2 value is 0, reduced to 0 minus 0.1, okay, into area 100 into 10 to the power of minus 4 divided by T. What is the time taken, students, here? Time taken is 0.1. Okay, epsilon equals, just simplify, students, this is 500 into this minus. How much we can get? 50 students. 50 minus into minus plus. Okay? Minus 1 goes up means plus 1. Plus 1 and this is 3. 10 to the power of plus 3 and 10 to the power of minus 4. 10 to the power of minus 1. 10 to the power of minus 1. Now, epsilon equals to 50 into 10 to the power of minus 1. How much we can get? 5. B is the right answer. Just correct. I hope you return. Okay, next question. Next question. A flux pipe, in a closed circuit, of resistance, 10 ohm, varies with time t, according to, equation, okay, pi equals to 6t square minus 5t plus 1. What is the magnitude of inducer current at 0.25? Okay, students. epsilon equals to, that is, here first I will write the current, I equals to minus 1 by r d pi by d. Yes? Okay, pi the value given here, what do you need to differentiate? That is, d pi by dt. Yeah, by differentiating 6t, that is 20 minus 5. Yes? Just differentiate this one. 6t minus 5. 5, just 5. Okay, by differentiating. Okay, now here. I equals to. Okay, minus 1 by r. What is the value of r? 10. So what is the differentiation we got here? This is differentiation. That is differentiation we got from this. 12 into 12 t. T is how much? That is the value. 0.25 minus 5. Okay. Simplify this one. I equals to minus 1 by 10 into 12 into 0.25, that is 3 minus 2, sorry, 3 minus 5, but we can write 2, that is I equals minus 2. This is I equals to minus 2 divided by 10, minus is minus, plus divide, this is 0.2 ampere. Option D is the right answer, 0.2 ampere. Not on this one. Next one. A short magnet is allowed to fall along the axis of horizontal magnetic ring. Starting from rest, the distance fallen by the magnet. In 1 second. Questions? Yeah. A metallic ring. In that metallic ring, a magnet is allowed to fall. Then, starting from the rest, the distance fallen by the magnet, how much distance it will fall? Okay? Just use the formula. So nothing is given, just take one at time. Okay, we have the formula. S equals to acceleration due to gravity will attract 1 by 2 gt square. Right? Okay, now this is S equals to 1 by 2. What is the value of g? 10. That 9.8 will make as a 10. 10 into 1 square, 1. 2 ones are 2 pi's are. Okay. What is the answer? Pi meter. Once here, answer is pi. Okay, next one. A 2 meter wire is moving with velocity. 1 meter per second. Perpendicular to the magnetic field of 0.5 Weber per meter square. EMF induced in it will be. Okay. What are the given instruments here? First, velocity they given. The next, magnetic field they given. Okay. Just we need to calculate. Length also they given. Okay. Use the formula. Which formula you can use? You can use the formula epsilon equals to VLB. The formula. Equals to VL. What is the value of V? V is 0.5. L, 2 meter into, what is the velocity? Velocity is 1 meter. Just multiply. Epsilon equals to 1 meter. controls to one node. Option C is the right answer. Okay, next one. A metal conductor of length 1 meter, rotates vertically about one of its end at angular velocity 5 radian per second. If the horizontal component of the earth magnetic field is 0.2 into 10 to the power of minus 4 tesla, then the EMF developed between two ends of the conductor. Here, already mentioned, metallic conductor of length 1 meter, rotating. If a conductor rotates in a uniform magnetic field, then what is the formula you are having? Epsilon equals to B omega L square divided by 2. I two formula I told you. One is in terms of length, another one we can write in terms of area also. Okay, so in terms of radius. Okay, here epsilon equals to, okay, what is the value of B? That is 0.2 into 10 to the power of minus 4 into omega, what is the rotation? 5 into a length 1 meter, 1 square again, 1 divided by 2, right? Okay, epsilon equals to, this is 2 into 10 to the power of minus 5, okay, 2 and 2 get cancelled, this is 5 into 10 to the power of minus 5. This I will write in terms of micro, okay? Okay, but here the option they not given, 5, okay? Just we can write this one, 50 into 10 raised to minus 6, okay?
4.
Okay? But we can write that one, 50 into 10 raised to minus 6, okay? That is nothing but 50 micro.
Remember students.
We can look at the next one. A copper disc of radius 0.1 meter rotates about its center with 100 revolution per second in a uniform magnetic field of 0.1 tesla. The EMF induced across the radius of disc is. Okay, same students, derived previous problem is solved in terms of length. This is in terms of radius. Okay, formula. Epsilon equals to B omega R square divided by B omega R square divided by 2. Okay, substitute the values. B equals to, what is the B value? 0.1 into omega revolution per second they given, that is 2 pi mu. Mu is nothing but how much? 10 into R. That is the value of R students. We substituted R is 0.1 meter. 0.1 whole square divided by 2. Right? This is epsilon equals to. What we can get here? Just by simplifying. That is 2 and 2 get cancelled. 10 to the power of 10 to the power of minus 1 and that is 10 to the power of minus 2. Right? This is 10 to the power of minus 3 milli. 10 pi into 10 raised to minus 3. This is 10 to the power of minus 2 and this is 10 to the power of minus 1. Minus 3. Okay. 2 and 2 get cancelled. 10 pi into 10 to the power of minus 3. Okay? That is 4. That we can write millivolt. We can write this one as 10 raised to 10 pi millivolt. Okay, friends, I hope it's clear. Next one. Okay, Lenz law is the consequence of, Lenz law is the consequence of law of conservation. What Lenz law states? Okay, Lenz law states consequence of energy. It gives the consequence of energy. This question is asked in Karnataka State CET exam. Okay, I will solve it while solving the CET papers. I will tell you this. Okay. Next one. A copper ring is held. Copper ring is held horizontally. Horizontally at a bar magnet is dropped through a ring. Bar magnet is dropped through a ring with its length along its axis of the ring. The acceleration of falling magnet while it is passing through the ring is. Okay. This is the circular ring. Okay, this is circular. What they are doing here? The magnet is dropped. Magnet is dropped. Then this acceleration is reduced. Why the acceleration is reduced? When magnet is moved through, when magnet is moving through the coil, then EMF is induced. If EMF is induced, then its acceleration decreases. How it is? How many times it is increased? It is less than the acceleration of a gravity. It is less than acceleration of the gravity. Less than due to gravity. Okay, students, remember this question. I hope you clear. Okay, next one. A coil has an area of, coil has an area of 0.05 meters square. 0.05 meters square, and it has 800 turns. Has 800 turns. It is placed perpendicular to the magnetic field strength. Perpendicular to the magnetic field strength. By 4 into 10 to the power of minus 5 Weber per meter square. Rotate through 90 degree. Rotate through 90 degree in 0.1 second. 0.1 second. The average EMF induced in the coil. Students, what are the things they given here? Area they given. Okay. Number of turns they given. And strength of the magnetic field. Rotates through 90 degree. Use the formula. I told you. This is simplified formula. Here are directions. Epsilon equals to NBA cos theta 2 minus cos theta 1 divided by T. Divided by T. Okay, now epsilon equals to, just to simplify, I substitute the values 800. That is down on next ones. Epsilon equals to 800 into, what is the value of B? B magnetic field is 4 into 10 to the power of minus 5. Okay, into area, that is 0.05. Okay, cos theta, cos, what is the value of cos? 90. Okay, minus cos 0, okay, divided by minus, divided by t, that is 0.1. Okay, simplify students, yourself is simplified. Cos 90 is 0, here cos 0 is 1, minus 1 into minus plus, okay, 800 into 4 into the power of 5. Just simplify, but the answer you can get, you just check this. Okay, let's check. Now, I will wind up here, students. We will wind up. Next, I will continue. 2019 to 2014 Karnataka State CET question papers. 2019 to 2014 Karnataka State CET question papers. Next class, I will continue. Okay, thank you.